From the Chronicle Podcast Network, this is the Skin Spectrum Podcast, your weekly conversation about ethnodermatology. This discussion is all about our skin, the doctors who treat it, and the diverse patients who live their lives under it. On today's Skin Spectrum Podcast, we start off our summer series of weekly reports with a special focus on the Black dermatology patient. Our first episode of the Skin Spectrum Podcast Summer of Dialogue focuses on acne in skin of color. Our guests for today are Drs. Renita Ahluwalia and Juthika Thakur from the Canadian Dermatology Centre in Toronto. Here's their discussion.
Hello and welcome to the podcast. I'm Dr. Renita Ahluwalia.
And I'm Dr. Thakur.
We're dermatologists at the Canadian Dermatology Centre located in North York, Toronto. And I'm also a University of Toronto appointed dermatologist with clinics at Women's College in Toronto Western.
And I work out of Canadian Dermatology Center 3 days a week. And I also do some investigative work in artificial intelligence and dermatology in my spare time.
And acne is one of our favorite things to treat. And we're both pretty passionate about treating acne in skin of color. And there are definitely some nuances to treating acne and skin of color. So that's what we are going to talk to you about today.
I think it's a good step to sort of review our general approach to acne. We'll go over considerations, particularly in skin of color and what we think about. And then we'll discuss any like post-acne treatments, particularly for scarring and dyspigmentation in more detail as well.
So let me tell you about a patient that I saw today. So I saw a young lady who came in. She was skin type 5, East Asian background, and she was really concerned about her acne. And even more than the acne, she was concerned about all the pigmentation that the acne was leaving behind. So when we examined this young lady, she was in her 20s. She saw a lot of flat, dark spots that she was referring to as scars and a few cystic acne lesions. So she really wanted all these marks gone and the acne gone. So the first point that we discussed with her is mainly an educational point that the first step is treating the active acne, because it is the active acne that's leading to those dark spots, which is post-inflammatory pigmentation, which is not actually active scarring. So the post-inflammatory pigmentation happens because melanin, which contains pigment in the skin, when those melanocytes are injured, they spill out their pigment and leave those dark spots in the skin. So we explained that to her, and we explained that, you know, fortunately, that's not permanent scarring, but it takes a lot to treat it. So for this patient, one of the things we did to treat the hormonal acne was put her on a birth control pill, which is a good option, and added on some topical treatments for her too, that could treat both the pigmentation and treat both the acne. And so we can get into the specifics of some of those ingredients in just a moment. And then we also counseled her about good skincare, because sun protection is so important. As soon as you go out into the sun, you're going to get more pigmentation. So we didn't want that to be an issue for her. So sunscreen and a good antioxidant were also part of her regimen. Should we talk a little bit about some of the topical options that can help?
Yeah, so I usually gravitate towards 3 or 4 ingredients in my patients with skin of color. And retinoids are my workhorse. So these are vitamin A derived creams like tretinoin or adapalene. And these can come in combination topicals or they can be standalone. And retinoids are really good for the mild to moderate acne group that may not necessarily be hormonal, but it works on two fronts. The first is it reduces those blackheads, those whiteheads, and prevents future recurrence of acne, but it also inhibits that melanin production that contributes to post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So I like it both for the post-inflammatory skin color changes, as well as preventing the acne from further creating that dyspigmentation. I also like Finacea. Finacea is also referred to as azelaic acid. And this is good for my skin of color patients who maybe have a history of eczema or sensitive skin that would benefit from management of their acne without drying out their skin. And Finacea, again, like retinoids, inhibits that melanin production and that transfer of pigment from the pigment-producing cells, the melanocytes, to the skin. So Finacea is a good, slow and steady treatment choice for someone with sensitive skin, acne, and dyspigmentation. I always consider Aczone in some of my older patients who may have either a hormonal component or tend to get those juicy bumps, and it works really well for papules or bumps around the mouth or on the jawline as well. I don't know if that's similar to your approach or if you have any tips for us.
Yeah, no, that's definitely the three most common prescriptions that I use too: retinoids, azelaic acid, and Aczone gel. I find that they work really well. Sometimes if patients are complaining about stubborn areas of pigmentation, I combine some ingredients together, a cortisone, a retinoid, and a little bit of hydroquinone to help fade some of those dark spots. We also carry serums that contain topical tranexamic acid, like the SkinCeuticals discoloration defense. And that's helped a lot of my patients with their pigmentation too. But I find, you know, when the acne is quite stubborn, a combination of topical and oral treatments work really well. And then once we get that under control with a good skincare routine, we can focus on kind of the next step, which is if there's any other type of scarring going on. So, I mean, the key message that we tell patients is, you know, it's a process. It's going to take time, but we can get their acne better. And acne is one of my favorite conditions to treat because I see such a difference in patients' skin. So some of the other in-office treatments that we can do to help patients with both their active acne and their scarring exist as well. So with their active acne, some patients don't want to take some systemic options. So we have like lasers that can help reduce inflammation in the skin. But where possible, we treat the active acne and then focus on the scarring. So one of the treatments that's become really popular in skin of color in our practice is radiofrequency microneedling, because the radiofrequency microneedling targets deep into the skin, stimulates collagen production, and really gets rid of those deeper scars to improve texture, tone, and a little bit the pigmentation as well. And it's safe in all skin types, which is really nice. With skin of color, we have to be extra careful to not irritate the top layers of the skin, because then you can end up with more pigmentation. So it's really important to see a provider who knows about skin of color and the treatments that are suitable for your skin type. Because, you know, with chemical peels, there's certain ones that are safe, there's certain ones that are not safe. With lasers, there's definitely a lot of no-nos.
Right. And, you know, to maintain your skin and protect your skin from further discoloration, Dr. Ahluwalia mentioned this earlier, but sunscreen and photo protection are important measures. So wearing a sunscreen that has both UVA and UVB protection is really important. And there are great tinted formulations that are available for our skin of color patients. And I usually recommend, you know, applying sunscreen at least once a day in the morning and reapplying throughout the day, especially if there's sweating involved. It should be the last step in your skincare routine. And if you need to touch it up, there's also mineral powders that are tinted and available in different colors. So it's really a good option for brown skin or dark brown skin.
100%. And some of the things that are also in some mineral sunscreens also add like blue light protection, because there's some evidence that blue light causes oxidative damage, which can cause more pigmentation in the skin. So looking for iron oxide in your mineral-based sunscreen will give you a little bit of blue light protection, which is a nice added bonus to prevent more pigmentation. So there are some specific types of acne that are definitely more common in Black skin. One of the types of acne that we do see more frequently in Black skin are fine forehead and temple, small fine papules that often can be related to hair oil or using certain products in the hair. This is a type of acne that's referred to as pomade acne. So we see that quite commonly in Black skin. So sometimes switching hair products to more water-in or glycerin-based products as opposed to oils can be helpful. So staying away from heavy oils and cocoa butter help to resolve that. And then going on a nice skincare routine, usually just topical products to help a little bit with gentle chemical exfoliation and proper hydration of the skin to maintain the skin barrier. And a good sunscreen can really help that type of acne known as pomade acne. So if you see those little fine bumps on the forehead or temples, it's always something to consider.
The second type of acne or acne-related condition that I see quite commonly in my practice in Black skin is a condition called acne keloidalis. And that's a condition that often affects the back of the scalp. And patients with that condition get follicular-based papules and pustules, plus sometimes even the formation of keloidal-type scars, sometimes small little follicular ones, or sometimes even larger ones. And this is a condition that we see almost exclusively in young Black males. And treatment of this condition can be challenging for a couple of reasons. One, because the condition is often misdiagnosed or underdiagnosed. So if you have symptoms like that, or you know someone who does, it's important to get them to seek treatment from a dermatologist because it can make a big difference once that condition is recognized. So some of the approaches we take to managing that condition are antimicrobial cleansers. Sometimes we use oral antibiotics, a lot of tetracycline family antibiotics, such as doxycycline. Cortisone injections can help with the inflammation as well. And sometimes even topical cortisones can help too. And then there's laser options. Some people even opt for some laser hair removal in the area and surgical options to help destroy some of those surgical scars. So it can be quite a complicated problem that's difficult to recognize, but once it's diagnosed, treatment management can be quite effective. And then the third type of acne that we see a lot of in Black skin, we see a lot of in everybody as well. And the first case in this podcast kind of referenced that acne, and that's the hormonal type acne that's associated with PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome. It happens in all skin types, but there's definitely a predominance in Black skin. So it's important to recognize that. And these patients are just as troubled by the acne as they are by the post-inflammatory pigmentation. So it's important to make an approach, as we talked about earlier in the podcast, to treat those active lesions and also treat the hyperpigmentation. So those were just three specific cases that we see more of in Black skin. So I wanted to share that with you today.
I always recommend that if patients are worried about their skincare or they want to review their options, it's always best to get an opinion from a board certified dermatologist to review these options, make sure that your overall health is also taken into account when we recommend these treatments. I don't say it's just creams or pills, it's your overall goals of skincare. And we can create a map for you to achieve those goals.
That's such a good point. When we look at a patient, we look at the individual and we sit down and make like a 360 degree plan to help you achieve your skin goals. So if there's any questions, we look forward to the live chat or you can contact us at the Canadian Dermatology Center.
Thank you to Dr. Ahluwalia and Dr. Takur for sharing their knowledge and expertise. Join us on August 21st, 2021 for the conclusion of the Summer of Dialogue series, our live colloquium on Black skin. The Skin Spectrum podcast is produced from studios in Buffalo, New York and Toronto, Canada by Chronicle Companies, publishers of the Chronicle of Skin and Allergy and organizers of the Skin Spectrum Summit. Visit us at www.skinspectrum.ca or www.derm.city. where dermatology lives. We would like to thank our in-kind partners at the Nurse Practitioners Association of Ontario, the Canadian Association of Aesthetic Medicine, and the Primary Care Dermatology Society of Canada. Subscribe to the Skin Spectrum podcast at Apple iTunes, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts. This episode was produced by Jeremy Visser with assistance by Aria Impacaris. Research was done by Kylie Rabernick and Catherine Brenders. Until next time, thanks for listening. We'll see you again next week.